Hey guys, welcome to MD's Robotronics. Today in front of you, you see the robot controller M1 board and along with some accessories which you connect with it. So what I'm going to show you today is the use of RBC M1 LIB. So that's a library that we just came up with for using that with the WinAVR GCC compiler to program your microcontroller board. So basically what you'll be doing is you'll be using these libraries in your source code to control the speed of the motors and the ADC functionality. So as of now, the version 1 of the RBC LIB consists of functions to control the speed and directions of your motor, which when connected to the robot controller M1 board. And apart from that, you also have functionalities to interface analog input device to your microcontroller and use that analog input for any calculation. So you basically have the functions required to drive the motors and also the functions required to do the analog to digital conversion. So it's a very simple library which is available for download from the MD's Robotronics .in website. There's a link which says a library for motor controls, motor speed control and ADC. So if you click on that, you'll be taken to a page where you can see the details about the functionalities that's been implemented in the robot controller RBC LIB. So here you see you have some macros which is used for bit manipulations, and you see some functions which is for motor operations, and some more functions to use the ADC functionalities. And this library will be updated pretty soon to include support for LCD and also USART. So USART is my primary goal. So once I'm done with USART, you can use those modules to connect the Bluetooth module to your robot controller and use a serial communication protocol to implement that and do your communications. So let's simply go to an example code that's been defined here. So it says example source code demonstrating the use of RBC M1 library, and it says the source code reads the analog input connected to the first channel and drives the motor. So what I've done here in this particular source code is that I'm connecting LDR. So LDR basically gives out an analog input. So there's a potential divider configuration. So the LDR is basically a light dependent resistor. So the resistivity of this LDR depends on the intensity of light that's falling on the surface. So once you have a resistor in series with it, this complete system acts as a potential divider circuit. So this is the topmost part, and this is the other end, and middle end is the potential divided voltage. So how I'm gonna connect this, I'm gonna connect this end of the LDR to 5 volts, and this end will give me the potential divided voltage which is fed to the analog input pin of my robot controller board, and the other end is connected to the ground. So VCC, ground, and the analog output. This analog output will in turn be fed to port C bit 0. So port C is basically the analog to digital conversion port, and the bit 0 is the first channel, or the zero channel I should say. So what I've done in my code is that I'm reading the data, I'm setting my channel. So let me just show you. Okay, in ADC init, so this method will initialize the ADC peripheral of the microcontroller. Initialization in this sense means enabling the ADC peripheral and setting the required bits, which is the selection of the reference voltage. In this case, in this library, I'm using the AVCC pin for the reference voltage selection, and also it selects the prescaler value. So prescaler value here it's set to 128, so which gives us a sampling frequency of 56 kilohertz. So that's about the ADC initialization, and then you have ADC select channel. So this particular function sets the ADC channel to channel 0. So this basically reads the analog input from channel 0, and that is further processed. And going to the next function is the motor init. So this initializes the motor driver circuitry in this board. So what it basically does is it enables the port B to which the motor circuitry is connected as an output, as an output device, and it sets all the bits to zero so that no the motors doesn't turn. And then you see a motor speed control initialization function. Here, this particular function enables the PWM functionality of this device so that you can drive the motors. You can control the speed of the motors using the PWMs. So later when you see, if you move around, you see motor M1 ADC get sampled. So what I'm doing here is I'm reading the ADC. I'm doing a ADC conversion on channel 0, which I have set here, and the sample is directly fed to motor M1. So the analog to digital converted digital value is acts as an input parameter for your motor. So the positive value of the sign of the value indicates whether the motor should be rotated in positive direction or in the negative direction, and the magnitude of the value defines the speed of the motor. So I have one other line which says which drives motor M2 in the opposite direction. You see the sign here. So this rotates the motor in the opposite direction. So I'm again reading the ADC sample, and I'm rotating that motor in the negative direction, which is like anti-clockwise direction. And this process repeats. So let's see what this code does when burnt into the flash. So I have the code already written into the microcontroller, and what I'm gonna do now is plug in the peripheral so that the board is powered up and is ready to use. So first I'm gonna plug these motors here. So motor M1 goes there, and motor 2, and this is motor 1. So motor 1 is also connected and in place now. And next thing would be our the battery connector. So I'm using this battery connector to connect the board to this battery, or you can alternatively use a USB supply as well. So just you can see you have, there's a link on my website wherein you can visit and check out the configuration for the USB functionality. So I'm just snapping this connector in, and yeah, there it is. The battery is ready and the board can be powered up now. So let me just plug in this LDR. So as I told you, the top part will be my I'm just plugging this pin in there, and I'm going to connect this to 5 volts. So we have a 5 volt supply down here, and yes, the middle line is the 5 volt supply, and then the ground supply and the other terminal of this configuration is a ground terminal, and that I'll be connecting to my ground line here, which is the first line, and the middle pin, which gives us the analog output, is connected to port C pin 0. So there it is, port C pin 0. Yeah, there I have it now, it's connected. The LDR is all ready to be used. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch on my power supply, and you should see this jumper is set to use the external power supply. So let me see. So you see the motors are spinning. I'm just going to block my LDR. So you see there was a reduction in the speed, so the speed of the motor reduced, and as I take my hand off, the speed is increasing again. So the more the light, I'm going to turn towards the window so that more light is exposed. Let me just connect this properly. So what is happening here is that when I turn the LDR towards bright sunlight, the speed is increased. When I turn it away towards darker side, the speed is reduced. So I'm just gonna block there you see the motors are completely blocked because the LDR, there's no light which is falling on the LDR. Let me just expose it to sunlight and you see there's an increase in speed. And now the motors are rotating very slowly. I'm just gonna cover up the LDR surface. You see reduction in speed. As I take my hand off, it's exposed to more light and the motor runs at a very high speed. So you can have a LED blinking, and if you expose this LDR to that blinking LED, you should notice the pulsing motors. So the motors, you can see the speed variation in the motors. So I guess you can hear that noise. So there it is. We have our own library to support you guys with the projects that you're doing. So this setup is very simple setup. So all that you need is this robot controller M1 board, which has a USB programming interface and everything, and the motor driver circuitry also. And we also provide you the library, so which helps you make your projects easy to implement. So stay tuned for some more functionalities on and around the robot controller M1 board, and I'll keep you guys posted about this on my website and also on the YouTube channel. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.